All right, everybody. It is 6 o'clock on a Thursday. And you know what that means. It is Ransack Radio. I am one of your hosts, Chris. Alongside of me, as always, Miker.
I am Miker, and I'm composing a tweet at the moment.
You are.
Yes.
You're always tweeting. I think you tweet in your sleep.
I tweet in my sleep.
Tweet in your sleep.
I tweet walk.
What's your Twitter name?
My Twitter name is at Ransack Miker.
You can follow me at Ransack Chris, and then you can follow the entire show at Ransack Radio. Why don't you tell them about Facebook, since you're the big Facebook guy?
Okay, what you got to do, you got to go to www.com. No.
Here we go. Come on.
Okay. RansackRadio.com. Find the Facebook link. Click it. Then find the like link. Click that.
It's just a couple things to click, but clicking's easy.
I feel like it's the least you can do. I mean, it's pretty easy.
Click. That's all you got to do. Click.
It is quite easy.
Hate to say it, man. This could be our last show.
Last live show. Yes.
Ever. Or until we get a new place to broadcast from. But that might be a while.
That's right.
Thank you, everybody, that's hung tight.
I know.
You know, the whole time through all the live shows. All the sketchy live feeds that we've produced.
That is right.
Through the years. Literally years.
So we're going out to some pretty cool bands tonight, I would say.
We got Buddy coming on the show at the end of the show.
We got Dave.
From All Hands on Deck hanging out.
All hands on Dave if you want to tweet him and maybe say something about Ransack Radio. Maybe get him pumped up. Get him.
Tweet Dave and tell him to send us the song.
Oh.
He still has not sent us the song yet.
You know, he's rockstarring us.
It's all right.
We deal with him.
So tweet at All Hands on Dave and say, send Ransack the song. Everybody, please. Do it at once.
Maybe he's still writing it. It's like that new. It's a brand new song.
They're actually recording it right now. They're finishing up.
They're like, cutting it down to the wire.
Got to get this bass track done.
But anyways, before that, we got another band on. Forever Came Calling.
Yes. Never heard of them before until just now.
Yep.
Excellent.
I know. I have a good knack for picking good bands.
You do, most of the time.
I like to think that my music opinion is the best music opinion.
Wow. For you?
Yes.
Yes.
It's because it's
mine. That would suck if your own music opinion sucked yourself.
Like, man, why am I even listening to this? I hate it.
I love crappy bands.
Yes. You know, I had this conversation the other day. I feel like cool bands, like like the All Time Lows,
A Day to Remember,
the All American Rejects. Like, when you ask them like who their favorite band is, they'll never actually say like anybody like
myself
within the genre. No, they will be like, I was reading through the AP magazine this week or this month's AP, and he's
you
like,
"You read?
I do.
Wow.
I have pictures. They had pictures in it."
I think this is the most shocking news we've had on Ransack in history.
No, but the kid from All Time Low, Alex, he picked Frank Sinatra. I'm like, seriously, dude, you're sitting there like just jamming out to Frank Sinatra. Like, maybe like you can respect Frank Sinatra, but I find it hard to believe.
New York!
Yes.
Yeah.
And like,
you can't really rock.
I was looking through all the people pick, but I feel like you, like, it's like a hipster thing to do. It's just like pick a band that. Or it's not even a band. I don't. Am I just blabbering right now?
It's fine though. It's this radio. You're supposed to blabber. I saw one of them pick Nickelback.
Yes, Asking Alexandria.
Yeah.
He was half drunk. Is that your half wondering?
Being weird.
Well, if he's not drunk, he's not alive.
He is Australian.
Yeah.
Nickelback's Canadian, so they have that connection going for him.
Yeah. No, he was saying it was like pure rock. I read that one too. It was pure rock and roll and sex. He says the lyrics might be cheesy, but it's all about sex and rock and roll, and that's what he likes.
All right, we got a band coming up.
Forever Came Calling.
Forever Came Calling coming up here in just a second. We're going to go to one of Mike's favorite songs because this is one of our last live shows ever history.
What are you doing to
me? RansackRadio.com. Hang out and enjoy.
Oh, snap.
Outside, everybody passed out on the floor. Last thing I remember was the girl next door. Somebody call my phone so I can figure out this shit I've done. Still drunk somewhat, why stop when the moment comes? Last night we were dancing on the table, swinging from the chandelier, singing. Last night I had to shut the tonight was a prequel, but tonight is a sequel. Getting high off the lights, this is life, this is what I do. I'm feeling deja vu, strangers telling me that I love you. Fuck it, I don't know why, but I love you too. Last night we were dancing on the table, swinging from the chandelier.
Mike or karaoke right there.
Was I live?
Breathe, Carolina. One of your favorite bands of all time.
No,
Eternity.
I cannot say favorite
of
band.
Eternity.
Song? Yes. Band?
No.
Not so much. But now we have Joe of Forever Came Calling. Is he plugged in, ready to go? Joe,
so.
Are you there?
Yeah, hey, how's it going?
Not too bad. We got to turn him up just a little bit. Are we?
Go, try it.
Joe, where are you at located right now?
We are in Santa Monica, California.
Nice.
Playing a show in at the Victorian.
Nice. Who are you guys playing with tonight? Anybody exciting?
Tonight is like a showcase for our friend Richard Gibbs. He runs this cool like kind of it's this thing called Metal. It's like kind of like a just a bunch of dudes who get together and discuss music, like what's going on. And he asked us to play a showcase for some of his friends. So just kind of hanging out, play a couple songs, see. If anybody likes it, kind of thing.
Nice.
It's like punk rock anonymous type of thing going on.
Yeah, kind of like punk rock with like classical music involved too. It's a little bit different. It's cool. It's just not what we're used to. But I'm excited.
So where is home for the band?
29 Palms, California. It's like it's 60 miles out. It's like 45 minutes outside of Palm Springs, California. 15 minutes away from Joshua Tree. Pretty much the desert, middle of nowhere.
Wow. So how long have you guys been together, this band, Forever Came Calling, been together?
We've been playing different bands. Like, the band's been around since I was in high school, but it was kind of a joke. We would cover, like, Senses Fail and Thinking Back Sunday songs, just because those are the bands that we loved. But it wasn't really serious, and then as we got older, like, it just kind of evolved a little bit, and we've been kind of touring full-time since January of 2010.
Nice. So what do you got planned for this summer coming up right now?
This summer we will be releasing our debut full length. It's called Contender on Pure Noise Records, which we're really excited about. It's literally like the coolest thing I've ever been a part of. It's just, I'm really excited for people to hear it. I don't want to like say it's like this or that because I don't want to like, you know, be that guy. It's like, yeah, it's badass, it's us, it's tight, best thing ever. It's just, I'm just really excited to be a part of it, and it's come out really well so far. And then we'll be on tour from May 25th through August 15th, I want to say. So, and I don't know when that stuff all announces, so I don't even know if I'm allowed to talk about it right now, but we're really excited with who we're going out with.
Nice. So I guess we just got to check back to your Facebook to see if you're coming up to visit us up here in the Great Northwest.
Yeah, it'll be in the north. It's a full U.S., and then the second part of it is just an East Coast thing, but the full U.S. will be the biggest tour that we've been a part of thus far, so we're all really excited. It's a band that we all kind of grew up on, so we're really excited to be a part of it and that they asked us to be a part of it, so... Go look out for that. It should announce, I think, first week of May or something like that.
Cool. Have you guys toured yet as a band?
Have we toured yet?
Did I miss the
go ahead.
Beginning of that?
Oh, wait,
never mind.
Go ahead. Okay. Yeah, we've been on tour forever, essentially.
Okay.
We just got off like a six-week tour a week ago, so we're home for 4 weeks, and then we're right back to it.
So do you guys have any like traditions before you go up on stage, or any anything that you got to do when you're at a venue?
I got really sick on this last tour, and I would just go up and I would just start singing right away, and I wouldn't really warm up. So now I kind of like start doing my breathing exercises, like get my voice a little warmed up, drink as much water as possible. And then, I hate when people say good luck. So break a leg is like key. Like if someone says good luck to me, I feel like it's bad luck. So that's one thing that it's kind of a weird thing. I don't know if it's a tradition, just one of those like weird little quirks I have, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah. We got to remember that if you come up and visit us, I will say nothing positive.
Yeah. It's like, hey, can I trust you now?
Oh man. Oh, sorry. So we are in. What was that?
Music video?
Music video, yes. I see that you guys have a music video for your song, Front Porch Sunrise. You have a few videos on YouTube, but that's the latest.
Yeah.
What can you tell us about that? In the intro, I see there's some kind of cool information. Why don't you tell the listeners that haven't seen it what's going on with your latest music video?
What it is our friend Garrett. He wrote it with us on a full U.S. that we did back in November. And we were, like, trying to, like, figure out, like, oh, let's shoot a music video. Like, let's do this. It's going to be fun. And we couldn't figure out a concept. We were trying. We even scheduled 3 days off in Oklahoma, where he's from, to, like, do this, like, big shoot. And then when we were a day away, we still had, like, nothing that we liked. And then he was like, you know what? Like, I mean, we've been gone for 4 weeks. We've done, like, 6,000 miles. Like, let's just use all the shit I've been shooting. Like, let's put it together. Let's get, you know, let's post something on Facebook, get some kids to a show in Tulsa, and then, like, let's shoot that, like, to the song, so, like, my mouth would not just look stupid, and I could, like, I wasn't singing on time. And we did that. We posted an event on Facebook, and we have some of the most amazing people and support system in Tulsa, Oklahoma, and Oklahoma City. So a lot of people came out. It was a lot of fun. It was just, it's a really cool way. And I think it represented us fairly well. It's kind of like a standard pop punk video, but there's kind of a little bit of work essence in there. So I think that was a cool way to kind of wrap it all up.
Nice. Have you ever been to like a stop on tour and you're just like completely surprised at how many people were singing along with you?
Yeah, it's weird. It's just kind of like over the past 6 months, things have changed really like for the better in a lot of ways, and every facet of the band has gotten just over, like, just it's been a great reaction. But 2 weeks ago we played in Manchester, New Hampshire. We've never even played out that far. Like, we've played New York and stuff, but we've never got to New Hampshire or Massachusetts. So we play, and then right when like, some kids were singing along, and it was cool. And I was like, this is a fun show. And then the last song that we played is Front Porch Sunrise. And as soon as we started with that, there was, like, just a crazy amount of people, like, stage diving and, like, singing along. It was just kind of, like, overwhelming in the best way possible. But, yeah, it was a huge surprise. Toronto, Canada, too.
Nice.
Like, another country. Their same reaction. It was kind of crazy. But that was the whole set, so that was kind of dope.
Yeah, that's got to be a pretty good feeling.
Now, up into to this point in time, what are you most proud of that this band has accomplished?
I think, let me ponder that for a second.
Mm-hmm.
I think that we're, I don't know, there's, like, we're being featured in this documentary called No Room for Rockstars. That's, it's about the Vans Warped Tour. We followed it in 2010, and because of that, we've been announced for Warped Tour summer 2013, and I think it's kind of cool, like, just because we're not from, when I say that 29 Palms is a small town, like, I can't stress enough how small it is.
Yeah.
It's population 20,000 people. It's literally, you know what I mean, it's in the middle of nowhere, and it was just, it's kind of cool to see that, like, we've been trying to push this thing so hard, and you know, like we're getting to play like, you know, a really cool like summer festival next year. That I think that's been kind of like the most surreal moment. We like Kevin Lyman announced this 3 minutes before we played the release party, so it was just kind of like, holy shit, I hope we don't suck tonight, you know.
I bet.
Yeah, Kevin's a good guy to be in with, yeah. For sure.
He's just a great guy. Like, in with him, not with him, he gets it. Like, he understands how this whole thing works better than anyone understands it. And it's just cool that, like, someone who has that much, like someone who has that much pull, like, you know, or clout, still is in touch and still, like, doesn't close his mind to different bands. And he's still about, like, the music. That's been the coolest relationship with Kevin and with bands. Like, bands is a huge company, and they've treated us amazing. They've treated us like family, and that's something that I did not expect at all.
So, Joe, we're talking with Joe of Forever Came Calling. Follow his band on Twitter. It's Hey, it's FCC. That's your Twitter name. What's up with that? How come you don't have Forever Came Calling?
Because our name's so long.
All right.
If we could, we would change our name to something like Ghetto Blaster. Or just, you know, like, I don't know, Forever Came Calling. It's just, it's so long and, like, drawn out and, like, over dramatic. It's ridiculous.
So that's the band. Joe, I want to get a little bit personal with you. Your Twitter is at JoeFCC.
Yeah.
So what is your favorite TV show, Joe?
My favorite TV show? Ooh, that's a fucking great question. Right now, I'm really into, like, scary stuff. Like, I don't know if anyone remembers the show Sightings, which was on in, like, the late 90s. Mm-hmm. Favorite current TV show I have to say right now is probably It's Always Sunny, which is kind of like that's kind of a given. But I don't know. I'm into so many different. Like, I love Lost. I love Monk, which is weird. But the show Beyond Belief, which I don't know if anyone's ever checked out, it's probably like one of my all-time favorite shows. It's Have you ever seen that at all?
No, I
have not.
I'm not big into sci-fi, unfortunately. I'm sorry, bro. I'm sports and comedy. That's me in a nutshell.
Okay. Beyond Belief is just, if you ever get a chance to YouTube it or something, it's this show where, like, this creepy, like, it's a dude that used to be on Star Trek. He does, like, five, like, stories on the show, and you have to guess which one's true or false, and they tell you at the end of the show. And I remember being, like, 13, and I was watching it because, I don't know why, bad parenting. It's just a scary-ass show, so I shouldn't have been watching it. But there's this episode where this kid is afraid of his closet. He runs in his closet. And he's like, no, I don't want to go in there. There's monsters. So his older brother and all his older brother's friends are like, oh, you're being a wuss, blah, blah, blah. And his older brother's finally like, I'll go in there. I don't care. There's no monsters. Older brother goes in there, starts screaming. They can't open the door. Dude disappears, and it was a true story. And I was just like, what the fuck? Like, yeah. Like, I was saying, like, if you ever get the chance, check out Beyond Belief. It had two seasons. And then I think they ran out of crazy-ass, like, monster closet stories to air, but it's a cool show.
I think I've seen the movie. Wasn't that Narnia?
Yeah, exactly. Narnia, but with a lot more teeth and blood.
Gotcha. All right, Joe, we appreciate you coming on the show. Your band, Forever Came Calling. Any last words before we let you go?
Do what you love. Love what you do. Jack Kerouac is a badass, and if you get the chance, read On the Road. It's one of the most inspirational novels you'll ever read.
All right, man. Well, good luck. Oh, shit. Not good luck tonight.
Yeah, not good luck. Break a leg.
Gosh, I already forgot about that. I'm sorry, man.
No worries.
All right. Well, if you come up to Portland, make sure you hit us up so we can come out and see you guys perform.
Yeah, for sure. I look forward to it.
All right. So that was Joe of Forever Came Calling. We're going to get to their song here in a minute. What is that?
Nothing, dude. Don't worry about it, bro.
I hung up on him.
Don't worry about it, bro.
I rockstarred him. So follow the band. It's at Hey, it's FCC. All of their stuff. I'm going to go out on a limb right now. I've went out on two limbs this year. One was that Don't Call It a Comeback is going to be the band of 2012.
I don't know about that one.
Dude, I talked to him. I talked to him on Gmail chat. He's got some stuff coming.
Oh.
My second out on the limb. Once you guys hear this song, you're going to be hooked. You're going to buy their merch. You're going to tweet at Ransack Micer and tell him how awesome he is for booking amazing. I'm sorry. Are we on Ransack Radio?
Yeah.
My bad. You're going to tweet at Ransack Radio and say, wow, Ransack Micer was right. Forever Came Calling is the pretty badass band. Instantly.
Sorry, it's not loading. It loaded so perfectly before the show started, and now it's not. Keep talking for a second.
Okay. Let's see here. Bands that you instantly fall in love with. I love that feeling. Avion Row, I did it.
Yep.
And I was like, well, gotta... that's like when I'm like, oh, I gotta get Chris. I gotta tell Chris. Okay, so we got the song. Like to me. And to get the name of the song is Front Porch Sunrise by Forever Came Calling. This is the music video. You can watch it on YouTube.
Seeing as much of this world as possible. With
and here
songs
it comes.
That I wrote in my bedroom that probably sucks.
This isn't good morning, this is gracious bad news. I was calling to scare you with what I'm about to do. You bring your sorrows and I bring mine too. You kept the ashes and now they're keeping you. What's it like to be honest, honest and happy? Say all the things that you know that you're thinking. What's it like to be honest, honest and happy? Say all the things that you know that you're thinking.
Came Calling right here on Ransack Radio. The name of that track is Front Porch Sunrise. Good stuff. Always a fan of the pop punk.
All right, hang on, we're going live.
We've got Dave from All Hands on Deck holding on the line. About to go live with him.
He's got some new stuff coming around, so
I like new stuff.
Did you check your Gmail one more time? Is it not in there?
I got Gmail open right in front of me. I got nothing. Checking the spam box.
We're quitting Stickam and we're quitting Gmail.
This is it, man. This is the last guest
we're
ever.
We're done with these
the
computers.
Ransack Radio.
Well,
history.
For now. For now. It kind of kills your hype up. Plug him in. Let's get this ball rolling.
I am trying, my man.
Dave, are you with us?
Hey, guys. What's up?
Not too much, man. What do you got going on tonight?
Tonight? It's Thursday, dude. It's Thirsty Thursday.
Thirsty Thursday.
That's my man.
Drink of choice?
I don't know. Actually, I got this beer that's like La Fendilia or something. I don't know. I never heard of it before, but it comes in a 4-pack and they're 9% alcohol each one. So
okay,
I'm
going to
take those down before I go out.
I can hang with that.
I saw you twit pick a rather large orange looking slushy alcoholic drink a couple days ago.
Yeah.
What was that? That looked good.
That was a strawberry lemonade, but alcoholic, obviously.
Oh, okay. You almost made you almost made it sound like it was something that you invented. It was like it was a what do they call strawberry lemonade
with booze.
For the people watching that don't know who Dave is, we call him Dave because we're friends. He's in a band.
Yeah. And it's his name.
Yeah. Oh, I guess that's why we call him that. But he's in a band called All Hands on Deck. Dave?
Yes.
What can you tell the people about your band that haven't heard it?
We're a pop punk band from Connecticut that are cool, and we like to party.
That's right.
They do like to party.
Yes, we can always check them out. So what's going on, man? We were supposed to have a song. It didn't come over, but we can get that later. It's not a problem.
Yeah, I mean, I told my drummer to send it over to you. He's been drinking already, so I mean, once I get to his house in like 15 minutes, I'll just send it right when I get there. I can't believe he did it.
No, that's all right. So that song is off your guys' new, is it an EP or is it going to be a full length?
It's just a 4-song acoustic EP.
Oh, cool.
Now,
Paper Heart.
Oh, go ahead.
Why
acoustic this round instead of the old pop punk?
I don't know. I just figured in the process of like writing a full length, mm-hmm. like I had these like 6 songs, acoustic songs that I just been playing, and I figured to keep things fresh, might as well in between a full length and our last EP, might as well just release a 4-song acoustic EP. So the guys let me go in and record my songs, and they like them, so they're gonna release them.
Very nice. Did you play guitar, or did you have the guy from the band play?
No, I play guitar, everything. I play guitar when we play shows, too. We have 3 guitar players.
Oh, nice.
Very nice.
Yeah.
So you guys got any plans for summer coming up?
Yeah, we're gone all of July.
Nice. Where are you headed?
Home on the July. Actually, I don't think we're coming out your way yet this month, but we'll be every state on the East Coast. Florida, Texas, Alabama, Mississippi, and I don't know. I know we have like 3 dates in Florida, and I'm so pumped.
Oh, nice.
But hopefully, like September, we're pushing towards getting like the West Coast. That's like our whole goal, like before this July tour. Like, we're trying to book it so we come home and like record this full length and then try to hit the West Coast.
The West Coast is tough. We got big states out here.
Yes.
Yeah, a lot of driving. A lot of driving.
I think a lot of bands avoid the West because of that. There's not very many cities to play. You got to drive, 4 or 5 hours in between
at least
any big city.
Yeah, but we definitely want to get out there. Like, that's our plans for this year. So
nice. How about music videos? Anything going on for Paper Hearts? Or are you guys going to wait until you play something a little more harder?
for music videos?
Yeah, you got anything lined up?
No, we've like talked about it and like have ideas for it, but never really like got in touch with like people that do them. So I mean, we're thinking about it, but we'll probably wait till the full length.
Well, just so you know, you do have 2 extras that are willing to leave at the drop of a hat.
Dude, well, you guys can do. Well, when we're out there in September, hopefully we'll just film it out there.
There
Perfect.
We go.
I like it.
Work everything about Ransack. You know what I like about Dave is that he doesn't have to, talk to the other bandmates. He's just like booking things.
Yep. Makes decisions.
Yeah,
decision maker.
Yeah, screw them. Screw them.
Yes. So Dave, we can't get to your new song. So what would you like to talk about?
Dude, I don't know. Actually, our song is up on our Facebook page.
Oh, okay.
Well, let me see if I can bring this up.
Yeah, that's not too hard.
It's called A Wasted Chase. It's up there. It's been up for like a week. It's not downloadable yet, but it will be soon. This EP was supposed to be out like by now, like this month. But I got like, I was sick for like the past 3 weeks. I couldn't go record. Like, so like I have to finish like 3 songs. I actually, the 3 that aren't released, I have to go finish vocals. So I got to start that next week again. Finally got over like being sick.
Nice. And we actually have a request in the chat room. Somebody said, well, since that you kind of dropped the ball on sending us the song, how about you sing a lyric or two to us live right now?
You want me to sing a lyric?
Yeah, just, you know, step up to the plate. Let's hear it.
I'll talk one out.
There you go.
I think my favorite on the song that's up that hopefully you guys can listen to is "She'll steal your heart so distractingly tasteful to tear apart so tastefully tactful."
Oh,
that would be hard to sing.
Yeah, I think that's a tongue confused. Twister.
It's a tongue twister. Yeah, it is.
Did you write that?
Yeah, I write all the lyrics and most of the guitar. But I don't want to take credit. You know?
All right, I got the song up. Hopefully it'll load. And so when we're ready, we're ready.
All right.
Yeah, it's a nice little chill song. That's what this EP is aiming towards. Just because the song we released, the things you miss the most, like people really, really liked it a lot. So kind of that feel.
So, Dave, people can follow you on Twitter at All Hands on Dave. Is that correct?
Yep. All Hands on Dave. The band is at Ahad Music, and all the band members' Twitters are up there.
Nice.
Follow us. Talk shit to us.
All right.
They love it.
Hate to have such a quick interview. It was a nice catching up with you, though, Dave.
Absolutely, guys.
So we're going to get to his song right now. I'll talk to Dave.
All right, here we go. Here's a brand new song from the boys and All Hands on Deck called A Waste of Chase, but you got to hold tight just for a second because I got to set some shit up.
Yeah, for sure.
Here we go. Let's see if this works.
What she means and how I can't be friends with the girl in my dreams. Built up walls that no one can break into heart like a hand grenade. She holds the pin and pulls me in. It's Russian roulette and I don't win. The nights I slept in your bed would always fuck with my head while the fits move slow. My eyes undress your so distractingly tasteful to tear apart so tastefully tactful.
Your tight jeans are begging me,
begging me
to get them off, to get off easy. And you're the danger in gambling. A safe bet doesn't mean you'll win a thing.
One more and she's out the door.
A blue moon leaves her halo on the floor. Twisting tongue, smoke filled lungs. She'll cover you.
Come on, just show me a
just fine. Either one will be just fine. For now. And you're classically the worst thing for me. And I'm making it way too easy. Just make your lies while you're trying to fake it. And every second is a minute that we're wasting. And you're classically the worst thing for me. And I'm making it way too easy. Just make your lies while you're trying to fake it. And every second is a minute that we're wasting.
I like it. What were you saying?
Brand new track right there.
Brand new track.
You
can only find it on their Facebook. Are they the type of band you have to like to get the song to play?
No, because I am not signed into Facebook right now. And we are listening.
Can I just tell you that I hate that feature so much? So this is what All Hands on Deck normally sound like. So switching it up to acoustic is kind of a nice change, I bet. I know nothing about the guitar, as you can see when I just when I do things. Like Crocodevin mentioned earlier, she goes from air drums to air bagpipes.
Oh, nice. Air bagpipes. I have not heard that one.
It's not an easy one to do.
All right, man. This is it, dude. Last live show ever. Any final thanks you want to throw out there? Last time, the Twitter bomb.
Twitter bomb. Let's get your Twitter bombs. So thank you all for watching, as always. Make sure you follow us at Ransack Radio and at Ransack Miker. Also, you got Chris over here at Ransack Chris.
Yeah, pimp my Twitter.
That's right. And for the people that always are here and always so happy to be here, we have at Alex Was Here. That's two X's. At Acadie to Remember. At Croc O'Devon. D-E-A-V-O-N.
Devon.
At Jackie_X. She's from Europe and she tweets
like
the perfect
American
amount. At Jen the Gypsy. Positively Jen the Gypsy. Follow her on Twitter. Follow at Big Hat Tover. Actual Twitter name, Kelly Ann Tover.
Isn't it just K Tover or something?
No, I think it's Kelly.
Is that her?
Don't question.
Her sticky M name.
Throw me out.
Sorry.
At Melly Cakes. No!
Mac Melly.
Mac Melly, she changed it.
With two E's.
With two E's.
Playa.
Because one E just wasn't enough. She had to pop another E.
Ooh. Feeling good.
And then always at Pixie Music Life. Follow her, the assistant. Did we miss anybody? Follow at Ahod Music and at Hey, it's FCC.
Yeah.
And like, seriously, if you're
we did not miss you, Crocodevin.
If you liked the show, tweet the bands and let them know.
Hey, I heard you guys on Ransack Radio and I thought it was splendid.
However, I feel that at Mac Melly and at Crocodevin didn't actually listen to the show tonight. I think they were just reading Dr. Seuss books.
Filling up our chat.
Yup. So, yeah. So you really think this is it, Chris?
This is it, man.
For the live shows?
This is it for the live show.
Well, for the record, at H0LY Cats, that's Holy Cats with a zero, she tweeted us and says she's not home, but she loves us.
Aww.
Something like that, I forget. All caps, so it must have meant something.
What a gal.
Yes. At Mitch But RY was in the background tonight. I don't know her Twitter name, it's something like that. Hey, at Krista Fobbs just joined the room.
Oh, a little late. Right,
little late.
We're even.
Just missed it. That's Krista Fobbs.
All right. I want to thank everybody for hanging out in the chat room as always.
Is there
it's
an
awesome
after party?
No after party.
What?
No after party. This is it, man.
Goodness.
This is it right now.
Last
thank
Ransack.
You, Silent Mike, Miker, Mike, whatever the hell we call you. Thanks for hanging out all the time. I am C Rock.
I am Ransack Miker.
And you just listened to Ransack Radio on RansackRadio.com. Thank you so much for hanging out.
Goodbye, everybody.